Hello and welcome to the second video of the free IntensiveCareHotline.com mini course, a blueprint for peace of mind, control, power and influence whilst your loved one is critically ill in intensive care. The second video here I will teach you about avoiding mistakes you are making but you are unaware of and doing the right things. Remember, you and your family are making plenty of mistakes that you are even unaware of that you are making whilst your loved one is critically ill in intensive care. If you continue to make these mistakes, it'll stop you and hold you back from peace of mind, control, power and influence. As a first step, you need to look at what other families of critically ill patients in intensive care are doing, and you need to do the complete opposite if you want to have peace of mind, control, power and influence. Because remember, 99% of families of critically ill patients in intensive care have certainly no peace of mind, no control, no power and no influence. And that's why you need to do the complete opposite. Mistakes are manifold and are mainly around spending too much time in intensive care and taking everything the intensive care team says for face value. Other mistakes from families of critically ill patients revolve around their poor mindset when it comes to dealings with the quote-unquote perceived power and the quote-unquote perceived authority of the intensive care team. Families don't challenge their own perceptions, let alone challenge their perceptions when dealing with a quote-unquote perceived power and quote-unquote perceived authority such as the intensive care team. Remember, it's only perceived and you can let go of that perception. By you holding on to making these mistakes, it will ultimately put the intensive care team in charge, will help the intensive care team to drive their mainly hidden agenda, and it'll help them to drive their decision making that is a direct result from what's happening behind the scenes in intensive care. Once you stop making those mistakes, then you can directly enter into your most powerful phase, which is basically managing the intensive care team, and you are in a position to counteract their strategies to manage you and your family. Avoiding mistakes is a leverage tool for you and for your family and gets you away from feeling victimized, and it's a direct shortcut to peace of mind, control, power and influence. Thank you for watching this second video of the short IntensiveCareHotline.com mini course, and I'll see you again in the next few hours in video number 3, where I'll teach you about peace of mind, control, power and influence even in the most challenging of circumstances that you, your family and your critically ill loved one are facing in intensive care.